Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Alrighty, what is up, my artist? Today, we're going to be doing another Austin Artist review. We're going to be taking a look at the show, the short-lived YouTube original show called Wayne. From what I remember, seeing ads for this on YouTube, because YouTube was hella promoting it. Like, it was promoting the fuck out of this shit. And I remember I tried to watch it, like, when I was in, like, keep in mind, this shit came out fucking a long ass time ago now. I think, like, fucking 4 years ago now? Maybe longer, actually. It might be 5 years now. But basically, like, I remember it being a weird show, from what I remember. It's apparent it's got really good reviews. So I wanted to take a look back on it and maybe see if I, because I don't remember much about it, so I want to see if maybe I could understand why it was so liked. Because I don't think I really got it the first time viewing it. I don't even think I watched the entire series, actually, now that I think about it. But I feel like I need to give it another chance. I don't remember, like, anything really about it, truly, that much. I remember it. I remember thinking it was weird. I remember the feeling while watching it. I just don't remember watching it, I guess, if that makes any sense. But yeah, let's get to Wayne episode 1. We're just gonna be reviewing the entire series, so let's get to it. Alright, season 1, episode number 1 of Wayne. Get Some Then, is what it was called. This episode started with Wayne getting beat the fuck up for putting bricks through some guy's window, and that was that. And then went to Wayne going back to his house. Wayne is also played by, he's played by Mark McKenna in this show. So that's who he's played by. But basically goes to his house, and basically his rent's due. They don't have the money because his dad has cancer and can't make the money, can't work to make the money and everything. And basically fucking Wayne hurts the goddamn landlord by throwing him a meat stick, like playing fetch with his dog that he had or whatever. And that was basically it. That then fucking we meet the other main character, Del, who she is played by Clara Bravo, which I'm pretty sure has, like, had a pretty decent, like, movie and fucking acting career in general after this. So yeah, but basically Del is selling cookies. We find out later those cookies are stolen by her, but basically she meets Wayne and they have, like, a romantic fucking chemistry, I guess. And Wayne asked her if they could be boyfriend and girlfriend or what the fuck ever. And basically she said to meet, like, her after he could get the money to buy some cookies. So he then tries to find a way to buy some fucking cookies so he could fucking be in a relationship with her. He gets suspended from school in doing so. And he finds out a way to make the money, buys a box of cookies. They are now dating. But as they're talking, her dad and brothers beat the fuck up Wayne. Wayne gets beat up a lot. Like, a real fucking lot in this show, it seems like. But there's that. Wayne goes home, gets stitched up by his father's caregiver, talks to the caregiver about just stuff in general, which we find out the person that he threw the bricks, the windows at, was her ex. So there's that, another underlying detail. Then fucking he talks with his dad, and he sees this car that his dad was going to give him and everything. And after that whole conversation, his dad passes away. Then in turn, Wayne leaves home and basically runs away to get the fucking car from Florida, because it's in Florida. That's another thing. The person who took it is in Florida now, and it's a whole thing. And basically, he gets Dell, beats up her dad and her brothers, and they leave for Florida, and that's it, pretty much. But yeah, first episode started off pretty okay. I don't mind it for what it is. I'm just gonna see what we get next out of it, truly. But let's get to episode 2. We have 9 more episodes to go, so let's get to it. Alright, season 1, episode 2 of Wayne. This episode was called No Priests. It was basically fucking about goddamn Wayne and Dell pretty much in Rhode Island, I believe. And basically, Wayne doesn't know where the fuck they're going. Like, they're going to Florida, but they don't know. He doesn't know the way because he forgot the postcard that he had that had the picture of the car on it, or what the fuck ever. And Dell's pissed at him, basically, and she tries to go to Los Angeles to leave him or whatever. And basically, this waitress or bus person or what the fuck ever she is, I don't fucking know, Tracy or whatever, tells her that don't leave a good thing when you, if you don't know if it's good or bad or not, or what the fuck ever. This episode was very, like, I just watched it and I forgot most of the parts of it. It was kind of very forgettable. It wasn't really that much of an episode, but another plot was Wayne getting taken by these two fucking assholes. One's like a fucking ex-convict, and one's a Satanist 30-year-old that he's dating, and they shot him with, like, fake bullets because, I shit you not, I don't get it, bro. Because apparently he was on their lawn, so that was the whole deal, and they had him held captive. So then Tracy and fucking Dell go and try to fucking pick him up and shit. And then the other plot line of the episode was Dell's father and brothers trying to get the cops' attention about Dell going missing and everything. And the cops has a whole side plot because apparently he has cancer and he's all talking about second chances and all this shit. Or he thought he had cancer, but he doesn't have cancer. It was so fucking confusing. I think they tried to do some comedy shit with it, and I really didn't fucking get it, truly. This episode was not as good as the first episode, I will say. I'm hoping it doesn't keep going down, because if it just keeps going down, that's gonna, like, turn into a negative review, and I was trying to make this positive, you know? But on that note, let's just fucking get to episode 3, because I'm curious to see where the fuck this goes now. And I don't know. It's weird, bro. It's really fucking weird. But let's get to episode number 3. All right, fucking season 1, episode number 3 of Wayne, the goddamned Beacon of Truth is what it was called. Fucking this episode was about them, Dell and Wayne, basically sitting there in the motel, trying to lay low after the whole situation that happened last episode, where they are now wanted, and they meet this fucking hooker lady, and she gets them a motel room, because obviously they can't get it themselves due to the fact of they are fucking fucked, pretty much, when wanted. They're also in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania now, so that's where they're at. Basically, a bunch of frat guys come through, and they're playing Truth or Dare, because Dell wants to have fun and lay low a little, and Wayne doesn't want to do that exactly. So they're all playing Truth or Dare, and Wayne does something stupid where he does a dare that somebody else dare got, like, he dared somebody else to do, but they were calling Wayne a pussy, so he decided to do it himself, and the cops got called, leading to them having to lay low. And basically they find out that the hooker lady fucking robbed them. So that was that plot line. The only other plot line that was in this episode was fucking the principal fucking his dogs. He had like 4 dogs that had died, and basically his neighbor had been poisoning them with antidepressants. So fucking he gets revenge on his neighbor by getting a like dog that's very dangerous, and he lets it loose on his neighbor, as well as he's taking Orlando, which is, I forgot to mention him a couple episodes ago, that's Wayne's like only friend besides Dell, obviously. And Orlando wants to go and help Wayne go across the country to fucking Florida to help Wayne. And basically he asks the principal to go with him. And at first he's hesitant, but now with all the shit that's happened, he's ready to go and give Wayne a second chance and all this shit. So that was the fucking plot line of this episode. It was alright. It was better than the last episode. That fucking last one was shitty. But let's go ahead and fucking get to episode number 4. Because I'm interested. But I don't know if I'm necessarily liking this show as much as people like praise it. It's all my opinion, of course, but, you know, I move, you know, so, yeah, but let's get to episode 4. We're not even halfway through this, so let's get it. All right, season 1, episode number 4 of Wayne. This episode was called Find Something Black to Wear. I don't got much to say about this episode. It was about Wayne working on, like, as a fucking, like, construction worker, pretty much. It was, like, freelance work, or what the fuck ever, get some money, keep your friends, the fucking, the others that are with him, and shit, and that's pretty much basically it on that front. The other side plot was Del wanting to go to this funeral of this girl's husband that she met at the pawn shop because of the fact that the pawn shop owner wasn't gonna pawn, let her pawn shit to pay for her husband's funeral. So Del helped her, and basically after that, Del wanted to go to her, like, his funeral, and that's basically what she did. There's one more side plot where fucking Del's brothers, it's their birthday, and they feel like their father is a dick. I mean, he seems like a dick anyway, but instead of being able to spend their birthday as their birthday, they spend it trying to get a fucking battery, a car battery for their father. And basically, fucking, they say fuck it, and they go get fucking flapjacks at this, like, diner, or what the fuck ever, and they get drunk, and they decide they're gonna beat the fuck out of their dad, but then they decide against it, because Del, sends them a message telling them happy birthday. And, yeah, that was pretty much it, honestly. When it comes to this episode, it's kind of middle of the road, if I'm being completely honest. It wasn't as good as the fucking last episode, but also wasn't the worst one, you know? I'm just hopefully the next one is going to be good. I'm hoping it picks up. It's the next one that showed, like, a preview, and it's supposed to be, like, a backstory for Del. So, I mean, that's something, at least. We're about to be halfway through. So, let's go ahead and fucking get to it. So, on that note, let's get to episode number 5 right now. Alright, fucking season 1, episode 5 of fucking Wayne. This episode was called Del. Just basically Del's backstory. I don't really have much to say, truly, because of the fact that it was just her backstory and why, how her mom passed and everything. It just told more about her family. So truly, I don't necessarily have much to say about it. It was an alright episode. Not terrible. I won't say it's the worst episode. I would say it's a little under middle of the road. Not something I would watch again, but yeah. And I'm more invested in the story that's going on now than more of the backstory. I'm not that big a fan of too many backstory episodes. So, yeah, I mean, yeah, let's get to fucking episode 6. So, let's get it. Alright, we have season 1, episode number 6 of Wayne. This episode was called Who Even Are We Now? This episode was about Wayne and Del still being on the run, and they stop. I can't remember where it said they stopped. I can't even keep track anymore. They stopped, and basically, fucking where they stopped, they mistake Del for a student. They took her back to that school that they in that vicinity, and basically fucking what happened was Del sits there and makes friends at the school, which it kind of makes no sense on how this even fucking works, because I don't think you're supposed to just take random kids, even if they're not in the system, and put them in school. That's not how that fucking works, bro. Like, seriously. But either way, she starts liking it there, liking the friends and everything, and basically fucking she wants to go to this dance, but Wayne finds the Los Angeles ticket from a couple episodes ago and thinks that basically she doesn't want to be with him or whatever. And basically Wayne goes and leaves, goes to a diner and gets some advice, goes back and wins her back. But fucking in the process of all this going on, fucking Del's family have figured out where she is, and they attack Wayne after the dance. And then when they attack Wayne, the people at the dance attack them in that way. So there's that. But another plot line was fucking Orlando and the principal trying to figure out the principal's speech that he has to do, and it doesn't go too well, so that happened. And then the only other plot line was the two cops from earlier in the show have been trying to find Wayne because they want to give Wayne a second chance or whatever, and they keep stopping at the stops that Wayne has stopped at. And basically fucking at the end of the episode, they find the video of her brothers attacking fucking Wayne, so they know where he's at and everything, and they're going to find him and shit. So that was basically the fucking episode. It was a lot better episode than the past couple, I will say. It's getting me excited for the end of the series. We have fucking 4 more episodes to go, and hopefully it keeps going down this route of being better. But yeah, let's go ahead and get to fucking season 1 episode number 7 of Wayne. Hopefully it stays on this course, but let's go and watch it. Alright, season 1, episode number 7 of Wayne. Episode was called It Will Last Forever. It was about fucking Wayne and Del. Basically, the aftermath of last episode, and Wayne and Del find out that supposedly, because the cops that are trying to give Wayne a second chance lied about Del's father. Supposedly, fucking Del's father is dying, which is not the truth. And basically, what happens is Del tries to go and say goodbye, has trouble with it, till Wayne helps her. They finally, like, actually kiss for the first time. They're officially together. Also, Wayne and Del escape after that, basically after she finally says goodbye to her dad. And fucking Wayne attacks the officer that is trying to help him, because he doesn't think he's trying to help him, and now the officer says no more chances and shit. So now he's going after Wayne as well. Fucking, we're almost down to the end of it. We got 3 more episodes left. This episode was good. It was better than last one, but yeah, fucking, I hope it keeps on with this fucking streak here. But yeah, let's get to episode 8. Alrighty, season 1, episode 8 of Wayne. This episode was called Must Have Burned Like Hell. Episode was about Wayne and Dell finding out that the person that has their car, has Wayne's car, fucking is the son, is Wayne's half brother, basically. Fucking, if that makes any sense. So Wayne is very fucking weird about it because he's talking with his mother and shit. And basically, Del tells Wayne that she's gonna leave him again, basically. And they go their separate ways. Hopefully that will get resolved eventually. I would assume so, because there's only a couple more fucking episodes left. There's only 2 more, which I'm kind of thanking God, because Jesus Christ, I'm getting tired. Fucking hell. But, I mean, the other side plot was Orlando and the principal fucking going to a strip club. That was just, I'm not even shitting you. Jesus. But we do find out that Orlando has a, like, a not the greatest fucking past. Apparently his grandma has dementia, and he has to, like, cover all the bills and everything like that, and there's a lot more weight on him, I guess. But yeah, that was like good story development, I guess. More of a story development episode, I guess. Truly didn't like this episode as much as the last 2. Fucking, it was kind of boring, not gonna lie. I mean, there's 2 more episodes left. Hopefully it gets better. But on that note, let us get to fucking season 1, episode 9 of Wayne. Hopefully it gets better and all that shit. But yeah. Alright, season 1, episode number 9 of Wayne, Thought We Was Friends. So, this episode was about the aftermath of last episode. Basically, fucking Dell is at a fucking public pool because, or community pool, what the fuck ever. She broke in. And she slept there overnight, fucking, and basically is fucked up about the whole situation, while Orlando and fucking the principal sat there, and they finally get to Ocala, Florida, to find Wayne, which they find Dell trying to leave. And they comfort her, and we then realize that basically fucking Dell has been getting helped by Wayne for years. So then her, the principal, and Orlando go to find Wayne. Now we fast go backwards to Wayne, and he's having a time with his mom, I should say. It a good time for him, but his mom is told to pick between him and fucking the other 2, or what the fuck ever. She chooses Wayne. Nothing comes of it, though, because Wayne tries to steal his dad's car. Doesn't work out so well, and he gets fucking tied up, and he's gagged and shit. Then fucking the cop from last past couple episodes is trying to find him and arrest him, comes and fucking sits there and beats up the guys that have him tied up in shit and basically arrests Wayne. And that's where we ended off for the episode. This episode was a lot better than the last one by a good mile. I really enjoyed this episode. We're almost done. We got one more episode. Fucking hell, I'm tired. It's like, I started doing this at like fucking 2 o'clock. It is 7:44. I do these videos, like, besides like my That 70s Show, when it comes down to some of these videos, I do them all in one fucking day. I'm just tired, man. Fucking. But let's get on to fucking the series finale of Wayne, episode number 10. Alrighty. Season fucking 1, episode number 10 of Wayne, Buckle the Fuck Up is what it was called. So, it's a little tricky, because this one, I just did some more research. Basically, I guess Amazon fucking sat there and, like, bought the rights to the show, but they haven't ordered anything, so I don't know what that means exactly yet. I don't know if there will be a season 2 eventually. I don't fucking know. For right now, I'm going to say this is the series finale. But I could be wrong in coming years. I don't fucking know. But this episode was about the aftermath of the last episode. Fucking Wayne getting arrested and Del trying to look for him. So Wayne basically has a talk with the cop, all that shit, cop's not budging or anything, and basically, after that, he has a face-off with the big boss, pretty much, or not the big boss, like, the person that has his fucking car, his half-brother, and Wayne fucking destroys his half-brother. That was basically it. Del and Wayne fucking try to leave, and then fucking Del's fucking brothers and father take, like, find them, hit the car, and take Del and leave fucking Wayne stranded, and Wayne gets arrested again, but he has Del's necklace to unlock his fucking handcuffs, and that's where it ends. The other side plot was Orlando and the principal, and the principal's dog fucking, along with fucking Wayne's mother. The principal's dog was having puppies, and that was basically it. That was legit the entire fucking story of the last episode, and it was okay. Like, I would have liked for a happier ending, you know, but I don't know, maybe that's just me, but I still think overall it was a decent show. It wasn't terrible. If it does get another season, I feel like I'm obligated to review it. I don't know if it will ever get another season, though. So, fucking, yeah, I don't know. But, with that being said, thank you guys for watching this Austin Artist Review. And peace. What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know? Why aren't you scared of me? Why do you care for me? When we all fall asleep, where do we go?